Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the official ARK podcast number 148. My name is Mistletoad, and I'm here with the core team. Your host for tonight, as always, the one and only Atlas. Take it away, sir.
Thank you for the introduction, Mistletoad. And folks, welcome back to another edition of the ARK Daily Podcast. Boy, are we excited today. Tuesday, March 28th. For most parts of the world. But here on the ARK, we have crossed a massive, major milestone. We've crossed the 4,000 ARK Vault accounts. Yes, sir. It's happened. Pinch yourselves. Smack yourself across the face if you have to. It is real. It is happening. And actually, we are at 4,014. And growing, we're seeing the contracts continue to print over and over again. It is an absolute amazing thing. Another milestone, liquidity on PancakeSwap has passed the 850,000 milestone. Sheesh. We are at 852,000. 303 BUSD, IOC reserves, nice and steady. We're still holding after that great buy that came in of $19,000 over the weekend. Smart money keeps piling in. We're at 419,410 BUSD. And of course, what you're all here waiting for, man, if I told you how many DMs I receive on a daily basis saying, Mr. Atlas, when, sir, when will I win the Spark Prize? And you know what we say, folks, it's not a matter of if, it's just a matter of when. And for some folks, how many times are you going to be able to win? We're currently sitting at 493.97 ARK. And if you're wondering, how much is that worth? What's the street value, Atlas? Well, little Jimmy, it's $2,820.57 worth of ARK that is going to be deposited here live on the podcast again for the 99th winner that we're going to find here. And tomorrow, another milestone, the 100th Spark winner, folks. Pinch yourselves. Smack yourselves across the head. Sheesh, I want my Spark, folks. So far, 22,777.41 ARK has been deposited into the past 98 winners' vault accounts, bringing them instantly into Nitro mode. And if you don't know how powerful that is, you could ask so many folks to hear live with us. You look around, you're standing shoulder to shoulder with such great investors that are so happy to be here on the ARK. They're earning, they're getting a win, and a massive win in the bear market with all the chaos going around, with all of the Wells Notice, with all of the banking. Folks, everyone here on the ARK is so calm, cool, and collect it. And if you're stressed out, come join us on Mondays. We have Coach Roberto live here doing some amazing breathing techniques that are just hitting that reset button, getting you right back into the game focused. We don't have to stare at charts. We don't have to see what Bitcoin or Ethereum did, what color pajamas Vitalik Buterin is wearing on stage, ETH Denver, or any of these GDC events. We're here counterbalancing, hedging our funds against the printers that be. Federal Reserve quantitative easing, tightening the belt. Oh, man. It's an incredible thing. And the only regret I think that we can have is that we have not brought in more people yet. There's so many folks out there facing the decaying fiat that's happening, whether it's cash under the bed, in a box of shoes, or in the bank. They're under the effects of that invisible taxation. The rumors are going around. They're going to print $2 trillion more. I mean, just recently, in the past couple of days, it was $300 billion. All the quantitative easing they did for a year, they just wiped it all in a day with $300 billion. That's a drop in the pan. So this is the place you have to be, folks. Pat yourselves on the back. Shout out to the person sitting next to you and let them know, boy, are we happy to be here? Are we calm? Are we excited? Are we smiling face to face? Oh, you better believe, because we are getting this crypto.
Oh, yeah. Let's get this crypto.
Baby.
Oh, God damn.
Oh, yeah. Let's get this crypto.
And with that, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Brett Nordine for some fantastic updates of what's happening here behind the scenes. Hope you're doing well today, Brett.
Doing good. Yeah, lots of utility testing going on and more roadmap presentation stuff. It's the primary stuff I'm working on. So, yeah, you and I are digging deep on some of these utilities and testing through and walking through and understanding, you know, where we can make some tweaks, improvements, and getting ready to make some big updates to our roadmap and how we're going to position and present these utilities. So, yeah, I'm excited. The next, you know, 3 to 6 months is going to be an exciting ride. So if you're here on the ARC, you're in the right spot. Yeah, as you mentioned, I think inflation is going to get much, much worse. I've just been kind of following some of the news. I don't really dig too deep since we're so busy, not enough time in the day on the project side, but yeah, I think more inflation's coming. I think that you know, they're going to try to create the narrative for the interest rates, but that's just playing right into, you know, exactly what we've been talking about, hedging into crypto, getting out of the traditional banking system, which still isn't secure. And I think we have more of these, you know, small bank exposures and maybe even one major bank that could end up in big trouble, which will, you know, be another great excuse to print more money. So I think it all plays in the favor of the, you know, the Fed trying to own it all. And at the end of the day, create instability so they can introduce a new flavor of their fiat currency through a CBDC. So we need to be prepared, stay vigilant. I think our roadmap is going to reflect, you know, giving people these choices and options that we've talked about. And I think that's really important as we move forward this year. As the volatility is happening around us, you know, we are calm, cool, collected, but also, you know, I really don't pay attention as much to crypto anymore since I've been on the ARC. It's a really nice, stable environment to be in. If you're following headlines and chasing headlines, it's going to be chaotic, I think. You see, you know, one bit of news that's positive and one bit of news that's negative for crypto, either way. So they're trying to create the confusion, obviously, and control the narrative. But in the meantime, they're building all these rails and these systems to put in place. So that's what we're doing. We're building our own rails and systems to, you know, allow us to operate in that parallel decentralized economy. So, yeah, I think we're at the right place at the right time and poised for massive growth once the rest of the world kind of catches on to what's happening. But in the meantime, you know, steering people out of the chaos and keeping them in a very, you know, steadfast and unemotional mindset is super important. So, yeah, glad to be part of the team and working on these things for everyone, for all. And we're going to introduce some things, I think, that can really help people. So, yep, that's what we're working on. That's what I'm looking forward to. And, yeah, chipping away every day. Alice, did you have anything else you want me to cover?
Sorry, I was muted. Thank you for the update, Brett. And couldn't agree with you more. I mean, these folks came here for passive income and they're getting it. You know, the Brett has spoken, ladies and gentlemen. We are building, we are working harder than they are. And we're printing a lot faster than they are. But fortunately, we're all on the right side of the printers here. And bringing these products and utilities on board, we're really going to be able to attract and help. It's like throwing that life jacket or you know, the inflatables, you know, for the folks to be able to stop from drowning out there. It's really rough. And here we have an amazing offer during uncertain times. And our narrative has been from the beginning, you know, beat the bear market, you know, starting with the crypto victims, the folks drowning at the bottom of the ocean and what we call here that crypto abyss. But now it's not just about the folks that had a very hard year in crypto. It's about the normies. It's about the folks out in the real world who don't even know crypto, who aren't spoiled the way we are, understanding that we can get high yield. And we've experienced the days of the 100x in 3 hours. Boy, have we had a good time. Those days are over. It's not happening. On the other side of the real world, crossing that bridge, we see so many desperate folks who are facing, you know, a fiat that were born into. Some folks here, like Mr. Big, I mean, he remembers the silver dollars. He can go back to when there was actual, like, you know, real assets that you know, coincided with what you spent and how an economy would be backed and flow. And for the folks from the UK, you probably remember, you know, their silver, you know, currency as well. They called it the sterling pound. They still call it, but there's no sterling there. Funny fact. So we're just more excited every day, and we feel a responsibility to be effective in our outreach, in our way to connect with so many folks around the globe. And every day is going to be an amazing opportunity to invite somebody new, to educate them, and to show them that there is a much better way and how they can be their own bank. As we see, they're not trying to kill crypto. Do not be fooled. They're trying to control crypto. You know, there's over 1,200 banks that are selling Bitcoin, you know, but they want to transition everything into that. They want to get their inside position, and they want to custody in their vaults your cryptocurrencies, my friend. They don't want you to have your keys. So this is definitely a battle for dominance. And we understand that in DeFi, we have the freedom to be outside of the matrix and to be in control of our own destiny and sail to where we're able to earn, and possibly for some folks here as they retire, as they come into their wealth, maybe move to a different part of the globe where they're valued and they're respected as a crypto investor. With that, I want to turn it over to the Mistletoad and find out what's happening on the All Aboard.
Yeah, so today we have Jashan. I know he's in here, but I know he said he was working during the podcast now. Jashan, are you here?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, perfect. He is here. Yeah, so he actually just posted a new YouTube video on his new channel. I don't know if you want to talk about it a little bit.
Yeah, just quick. I'll just give some quick background. If you've been here for a while, you've probably seen some of my Medium articles. I got into Medium with the initial creators contest back in December. I've written 3 other articles since then. I really wanted to get into YouTube, but I'll tell you, I'm sure a lot of people say this too. I'm probably my biggest critic, so I couldn't really pull the trigger. Probably got hours of footage on my computer that's been deleted, or some of it even where I forgot to record the audio. So it's been a long time coming for me. I think everyone here, we say this kind of daily, so I'm kind of preaching to the choir, but I really can't overstate how extraordinary the community here is at ARK, and encouraging this type of creative outlet. And I don't really think that a video or an article can really capture that essence. I'll just anecdotally kind of tell this quick story. And if you're here early enough, you know Atlas will get on there and he'll see who's around. And kind of does like a roll call and calls people out. And one of the days they did that, he called my name out. My 13-year-old son was walking by and he knows my online monikers. And he kind of, you know, jeered and said, "Oh, dude, they called your name out." And I said to him, I said, "You know, son, I'm kind of a big deal." And he rolled his eyes and ran up the stairs. But the big thing here is that is what being a member of the art community makes you feel like. It makes you feel like you are a big deal. And it doesn't matter how little your involvement is, whether you're a whale, whether you're a big time investor. It just has that effect. And tying that into the video, I think that we all, you know, innately want to be creative. We want to build something. And I know for me, I've been working at my job and nothing against my job almost 20 years, but it's pretty much sucked the creative life out of me. But being involved in ARC and being passionate about something again, and just being encouraged to create the content, whether it's Medium, whether it's videos, that encouragement goes a long way. And then the feedback that we get, and everybody has their own story. And it's just fantastic, you know, to either listen or to read the content from the other creators. And most of the time I'll get on all aboard, and sometimes, you know, you might be in a pinch and you do have, like Coach Brad says, it takes 3 minutes. But I'll tell you, most of the time when I'm in there and I'm clicking on these links and I'm going to these YouTube videos or I go to the articles, I've already read them because it's exposed me to the community members and I've subscribed. And even the stuff that's not ARC related, I'm watching these videos. It just, you know, these guys are part of the community. And I think whether you engage a lot, whether you talk a lot, whether you type a lot, when I do read these articles, when I watch these videos, and even when I hear the discourse on here, whether you're directly talking to me or not, it feels like you are. So this is just kind of my take based off my experience. And I hope when you watch this video, you get that feeling too, like I'm talking to you directly. And in a nutshell, it's a little bit more probably than just an overview of the video, but that's what it is for me to be a part of this community. And I hope you get some type of value or entertainment out of this video. Thanks.
Beautifully said. Wow. Give me chills just talking about that. Thank you so much, Deshaun. And yeah, your video is awesome. And I just applaud you for taking that leap of faith and actually going out there to post that video, because it can be daunting. I do know that feeling as a musician myself, posting things and you're your own critique. It really can get in your own head. But I would just say keep doing it, keep going at it, and you're going to become successful. So thank you, man. Thank you for sharing. All right, let's go on with the video. Deshaun, if you want to say anything throughout the video, just let me know. I can pause it and you can unmute your mic. Are you guys able to hear it?
No. Just like last time.
No sound. Atlas, are you able to play it? I'm really not sure what's going on with my computer.
Yes, no worries, my friend. We got you. If you can send me that link over here, we'll get it up and running right away. And meanwhile, we're almost getting close to another all-time high on the Spark prize pool. Our last all-time high was 499.22 ARC, almost broke the milestone of 500 ARC in a single drawing. So we might get there. Let's see what happens.
I just sent you the video there.
Thank you, sir. And everyone, thanks for your patience with the technical difficulty here.
I'll have to do some testing after this.
Yeah, we can do it together. We'll figure it out. But we're not missing this for the world. Man, this man talks from the heart, and he's very passionate about ARC, how different it is, how his investment here has had an impact in his daily life. I know he really touched all of us with his article about being a better father, a better investor, not being stressed out, looking at charts all day, and trying to battle out there on those cold crypto streets. Okay, and I think you guys can see it now. Is that correct, Mr. Mistletoe?
Yep, we can see it.
All right, let's go for it.
All right, today in this video, I'm going to be talking about ArcFi. I'm going to give a brief overview, then highlight one of my strategies that revolves around Foundation and Spark Rewards. I like to call it the five little ducks. Before we get going, I want to let you know, I am not a financial advisor and nothing in this video should be construed as financial advice. This video is documenting my journey. It is my opinion and for entertainment purposes only. Unless you've been living under a rock for the last several months, then you've probably heard of ArcFi and the Arc Vault. The Arc Vault is a daily ROI dApp where you earn up to 2% daily. A team of DeFi experts built this protocol from the ground up, utilizing features that worked well in other dApps and eliminating features that were detrimental and unsustainable. They also added their own unique features focused on sustainability and longevity. This is not a fork. It was coded from the ground up. The bottom line up front on this is you do start at 2% a day, but that 2% is split into a compound withdrawals. The default splits 50-50, which results in 1% compound, 1% withdrawal, minus taxes. And around the time you ROI, which is typically around 94 days, your daily percentage will drop from 2% to 1%. This further reduces the strain on the protocol, but you can bring it back to 2% by depositing fresh capital, buying more ARC, depositing it into your vault, or earning referral rewards from your ARC team, which is called a syndicate. And these actions are positive for the protocol, right? If you follow this default path, you're going to hit max payout shortly after you hit max wallet, which creates a much smoother and more sustainable process than other ROI dApps. The system also encourages you to take profit. Really, it forces you to ROI. It's very investor friendly. Now, if you want additional information, I highly encourage you search ArcFi on YouTube or Medium. There's so many fantastic videos and articles that do a deeper dive into the protocol. I do want to mention the white paper quick. I highly recommend that you check out the white paper on the website. Right here on the main page, it hits you right in the face. Boom, white paper. It pop opens a new window. And as I mentioned before, conceptually, the dApp is built unlike any other ROI dApp in the space. But beyond that, this white paper itself is a DeFi masterpiece. It's well written. It's organized. There's graphics. There's charts. There's pictures. There's videos. It's constantly being updated. Now think about this too. How many times have you searched for a white paper? You found it, and then you're looking for a specific detail or feature, right? You want to find it in the white paper. It's a pain. It's a huge pain. Some protocols, even finding that white paper is a chore. Now with ARC, you already know it's right on the main page, but they've also added something awesome to this white paper that elevates it to the next level. It has a search function, right? You can go in here. If you want to find out something more specific, maybe about NDV, about taxes, any function, type it in there and boom, it makes what you're trying to find a breeze. Now, if the website isn't your thing, you can also jump into their Discord server and they have each section of the white paper there broken down into little bite-sized sections, very easy to digest. The level of detail here and on the Discord is just fantastic. All right, let's talk about the team for a minute. We'll pop back here to the beginning of the homepage. We'll click on the team. Descriptions of everybody's here. I'm not going to go into any specific person. I'm going to just generally talk about the team, but the information's here if you want it. The ARC team is innovative. They're forward-thinking. They're transparent. These guys are available above all else, right? And that's very rare nowadays in the DeFi space. They're not hiding out in a banker or bunker or basement under radio silence, right? They're available daily on Telegram, Discord. Every day, there's a daily AMA. It's led by the team. And every person in attendance gets the opportunity to participate. ARC has really turned into one of the premier DeFi communities in the space. It's one of the best communities that I've ever been a part of. And in the immortal words of LeVar Burton, you don't have to take my word for it. Because you can join the Telegram, you can join the Discord, you can jump in and experience the daily podcast, you can ask your questions, you can do your due diligence, and the team will be there to answer your questions. And this team, they're constantly building. They're also very aware of the current economic climate, and they're focused on solutions that will benefit all of their investors. Not just whales or team leaders, but everybody. And they're super passionate and genuinely here to make a difference. There's going to be an updated roadmap coming out soon, but I'll tell you right now, if you're part of this community and you jump into these AMAs, we already know most of the stuff that's coming because this team is open and transparent. Every day in the AMAs, we get updates, we get alpha. The stuff that's coming to ARK is going to be big. It's going to be real big. And I really want to go back. I want to just emphasize their awareness of this current economic situation. And they're staying ahead of this and they're tracking it, making contingency plans and building out products that are going to help all investors fight back against inflation and this chaotic economic matrix that we seem to be stuck in right now. For example, one possible future product, a gold-backed and pegged crypto token. This would be huge. And ARK's going to keep building, right? DeFi simplified. I think there's already something here in this ecosystem for everybody. But if there isn't now, there will be in the future. And if you aren't on the ARK now, you probably will be in the future. Now, another great feature on the Daily Podcast, and one of my favorites, is the All Aboard segment. Here on a daily basis, we're introduced to the ARK community creators and their content. And as an avid consumer of ARK-related YouTube and Medium content, one thing I really like, and part of the reason why I'm making this video, is I really enjoy seeing other people's strategies. I know what my strategies are, but is somebody else doing something unique? Do they have a different take on something? I don't want to miss out. And we've seen max deposit strategies, keep my NDV positive forever, redeposit strategies, team building strategies galore. We're seeing team builders from Drip, like Brandon from Team Drip Guide, or Driptopian, or Cryptopian, whichever day name he's using, building teams and exposing their Drip communities to the ARK. And almost daily, we hear tips from the ARK Whisperer, Coach Brad, regarding his syndicate strategy. His syndicate is going to end up having more people in it than the white pages in an old school phone book. But regardless of your specific strategy, there's just so many ways to play the ARK. And there are so many ARK creators to draw inspiration from, and multiple tools available to chart your own path. All right, that was enough of an overview. Now let's get back to the strategy. Let's talk about Five Little Ducks. This is a very simple strategy focused around the foundation and Spark Awards. Let's head over and check out the product description of the foundation. The ARK Foundation acts like a savings account, paying a high yield in BUSD with the added utility of qualifying for ARK Vault referral reward levels and the Daily Spark rewards drawing. Now, for me, I love this concept. It's a DeFi savings account. My investment here will help build liquidity, which is great. BUSD in that's paired with ARK, which creates LP or bond, which is an incredibly stable pair. You have 10% tax in, 10% tax out. This, again, it helps with sustainability and longevity. But I also get, in return, an interest-bearing savings account, a DeFi savings account. And I'll get daily rewards, and I can decide if I want to compound or withdraw them. And if I have to, they're not locked, right? So if there's an emergency, I can withdraw my balance back to BUSD at any time. There's no crazy lock. There's no crazy conditions. Just 10% tax out. But wait, there's more. Because if I put $250 worth of bond into the foundation, into my DeFi savings account, I qualify for Spark rewards. So get the F out of town. I get this DeFi savings account and a daily chance to win Spark. Now that daily chance for me, that satisfies or scratches my inherent FOMO itch that I used to get on a daily basis. So I can take some money, risk capital, profit, whatever it may be, off the table, invested into this DeFi savings account, and still check that FOMO box. I absolutely love this strategy. Let's jump over to the DApp. Now, if you're not familiar with Spark, here you can see the previous winners. And each day, if your wallet is Spark eligible, you get a shot at winning the Spark prize. Now, in order to be eligible, you need a legacy NFT attached to your ARK account or $250 worth of bond in the foundation. Look at some of these previous winners, 426 ARC, 418 ARC. And today, as I'm recording this video, we're up to 425, and we haven't even reached the point where we're going to draw this yet. So to date, 95 folks have won, and they've paid out 21,310 ARC. This is awesome. So just quick, where do the Spark rewards come from? So ARC has a tiered referral system with round robins. Now, what ARC does different than most ROI apps or dApps is that when a compound is made and there isn't a qualifying wallet in the round robin tree to grab that reward, it gets sent to the Guardian wallet, which is similar to a dev wallet and other protocols. And every day, 50% of those rewards that the Guardian wallet accrues get raffled off in the form of Spark rewards. So the winner gets these ARC tokens sent to their vaults in the form of a referral reward. And this sends their vaults directly into Nitro mode. But it also does another thing. It boosts their NDV and it keeps their vault at 2% longer. So being eligible for Spark is a huge, huge deal. Now back to the five little ducks. This strategy is super simple. I've been slowly building up accounts that qualify for Spark, right? I have five kids, so my goal was five wallets, one for each one of my kids. Hence the five little ducks. Now each one of their accounts is now waiting patiently to hit Spark rewards and get sent into Nitro mode. But more importantly, each one of my kids now has their own DeFi savings account in the foundation. And this is currently my favorite ARC strategy, the five little ducks. Now, not financial advice, but my approach to this. As soon as I started, once I got to 350 BUSD, I created an account. I got my 350 BUSD, transferred it over to that account or that wallet, threw $70 right in here. $70 gets me 10.63 ARC. In order to get the ARC Vault account started, you need a minimum of 10. 70 satisfies this requirement. 70 out of that 350 left me with 280. So then I jumped over to Foundation. Drop my 280 in here. This gives me 56.8 bond. But remember, there's 10% tax in, and I can tell you with the 280 after 10%, that's giving you $250 worth of bond. So that was my strategy for each wallet. Get to 350, 70 into ARC, create the ARC vault, throw the next 280 into Foundation, and then boom, I have my account up and ready, DeFi savings account ready to go, and Spark eligible. So they're all under my syndicate. Let's jump over to my syndicate. So again, now I'm going to use the airdrop tool to narrow these down and show you the wallets. But just remember, the goal of these is the Foundation savings account, not the ARC vault. So I know that each one has no more than 15. Put 15 as the max. We'll go ahead and run the search. So here you can see these are my five little ducks. So what I want to do now is I want to show you a fantastic community-created tool, the ARC Multi-Wallet Dashboard. This wallet was created by Rick P., and I first found out about this tool from Kelly Snook's ARC Rocket Science Telegram. I love this tool. So these are four of the five little ducks already loaded in there. I will jump back to the syndicate. I'm going to copy the wallet address for the fifth, and I'll just show you how the tool works. Super simple, just like this strategy. Go ahead and paste it in, add the wallet, and then we just wait for it to pop up. Boom, there it is, right? So now you can see all five. We've got five little ducks, the five accounts. This tool in itself is awesome for wallet tracking, any type of strategy. It works perfectly for this strategy. You can track your legacy NFTs. You can add bond, which I've done for this. And what I'm more concerned about with my strategy, I want my $250 worth of bond so I can check this on a daily basis. For whatever reason, price goes up, price goes down. And as I compound and continue, I can see the value of all these accounts. Now I just got the fifth one up and running, so I haven't contributed anymore. So they're basically at 250. But then the other awesome thing is with the included bond, you can see this glorious green check mark, which indicates that they're all Spark eligible. So anyway, my friends, that was the five little ducks. The awesome thing about this strategy is it can be customized to your needs. It can be the dynamic duo, the three musketeers, the four horsemen of the Sparklets, the seven dwarfs, even the dirty dozen. There are so many options. If you enjoyed this video, give me a like. If you need a syndicate, consider joining mine. Huge shout out to the one person that's currently on my syndicate. I airdropped you last week, and there's more coming your way this week, my friend. I have several other ARK strategies that I can't wait to show you. I'm Jay Vanquish, and this is how I play the ARK. This is the way, and ARK for the win!
Wow. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, what a video.
The Four Horsemen. I love it, man. That was amazing. The Four Horsemen of Sparkopolis.
Dude, what a level of professionalism, enthusiasm, and man, what a script. Just what a delivery. Incredible. Sean, that's your first video from what I'm looking at here in your channel, correct?
That is my first video.
How is that possible? How?
Well, I'll say,
do you have like another channel? Like, dude, you're like a pro YouTuber level, like unbelievable. First time ever?
Yes. It was about 4 months in the making, though, because when I said at the beginning that there was a lot of deleted stuff and a lot of stuff that I couldn't let release, that's definitely true.
Wow.
And I'll say one funny thing is I didn't realize that YouTube allowed you to do automatic subtitles, so I also spent about 4 hours doing my own subtitles. So I just have custom English subtitles if anyone's interested.
Oh man, this is brilliant. The Five Little Ducks, like, oh come on, man, come on. I mean, I would expect this out of some of the top guys out there, but from a new timer, I mean, your article blew us all away, but this is just jumping into a whole different format, whole different. I mean, for a while there, I felt like I was the passenger, you know, in your spaceship as you're rolling through the arc, and you know, felt so comfortable to be there, and the energy so welcoming. I'm going to be quiet. I'm going to let some of these other people, because I'm sure their jaws are also on the floor. Go ahead.
Man, that video was amazing. I love the energy throughout the whole thing. That's just what I love about it. And the analogies, and oh man, you are a natural. You definitely got to make more videos.
I would say that, he's got like a radio voice.
Yeah, that's the vibe I got too.
I mean, God, I can sit and listen to him all day. Just give me alpha, 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 alpha. Just give it to me. I mean, this guy was awesome.
I would say, first of all, I know what you're talking about with writing your own subtitles, and then realizing 4 hours later that it. YouTube does it for you automatically. Just the whole editing process is so cumbersome, in my opinion. That's why there's a reason I do live streams rather than recorded content primarily. But the other thing I wanted to mention, it was clear that you had a script, and I've done that too. I've had unscripted recorded videos, and I've had scripted recorded videos, and I think you pulled it off really well, because you know, like I said, I could tell it was scripted, but it was also it came through really naturally. And the real point is that you benefit from having that script, because it keeps the video a lot shorter, it keeps you on point, and it reminds you, you know, you covered every single aspect that you wanted to cover. And it clearly was a well-written script even before you knocked it out of the park with actually delivering that script. So yeah, I don't even look at my first video on YouTube. Holy crap, yours is you're already 18 levels above. That was awesome.
You didn't Great have job. Five little ducks, Brandon. You didn't no. have five little ducks. In your first one,
this
came loaded, and he even quoted somebody. The quote was man, this was brilliant. How do you put something together like that? Sheesh.
More than one quote. Yeah. He quoted you. he quoted. Well, I know, he quoted you a couple times. I think.
It was a woman, and you know, you could come yourself, and you could join the Telegram, and you could do this. I mean, you had me at five little ducks, but dude, wow, good, yeah, right?
Oh yeah, I just wanted to praise because he put a lot. You could tell there's a lot of time and effort in that, and it showed. But I think you know, you broke the ice, and now we just want more. Where have you been all our lives? I mean, that's probably better than, you know, 95% of the paid YouTubers out there. So very well done, and I hope it returns equally to you, because I think you deserve it for sure. And if you can keep this kind of format, and you know, even if you did shorter ones, I mean, you could probably make 10 videos out of that at the end of the day, you know, that would probably be very beneficial to you. But yeah, I think we see another Zoom presenter in our midst too. So I was thinking the whole time, like, man, he could really help us with the Zoom presentation. So
Ark is hiring. Yeah.
Very well done.
And we've said this so many times, Brett. How many times have we said we are going to see content creators being born here, and mm-hmm. we're going to see their star rising? I mean, you guys have been sick and tired of hearing me say that. And you say these things, and we've said, you know, there's going to be so many great people are going to contribute that are going to come. Just have patience and wait. They will happen. You know, they're here among us. There's others that are coming, and it's such a wonderful reassurance when we see things manifest, when we see people step up, when we see Donatello dropping a video a day, when we see Brandon here, you know, when we see so many folks, and he even, you know, talked about a couple of them as well. It's one thing expecting it and working for it and understanding that we're providing that fertile environment and community where people can step out of the box and do something different. Do something for themselves, do something for their family, for the project, knowing that we're here to support them every single day and that it's really making a difference. So, man, it's overwhelming. It really is. Man. Who else? Catalyst. Because he started Medium and he just wiped the floor with us, man. He got us emotional. But now with this one, it's just an incredible level. Catalyst, you want to... give your 2 cents, sir, of your analysis. The most analytical mind here on the Ark.
I would have never guessed this was his first video. I was blown away when he said that. That's amazing. Well done, sir. Good work. I actually don't do videos myself, but I know a good one when I see it. So I think like Brad and Brandon, everyone said, keep going, keep up the good work. Yeah, maybe make them shorter and get more bang for your time and effort. That's all I would
I like
add.
The format.
I appreciate it. I like appreciate the comments from everyone, the opportunity to present.
Thank you, Deshaun. Even the music was on point. It was there. It wasn't, you know, it just flowed with and the volume level as well. It didn't overtake you, and it wasn't distracting, blended in perfectly like you know, freaking Hollywood production. And I personally like the length of the video, where people can go and they could get something out of it. I know people have a short attention spans, but as I was watching it, Deshaun, there's a gentleman who's quite popular in this space, to give you an idea how long he's been here. He and Black Sheep were the ones that came up pretty much with the, you know, whole concept of the ROI dap and whispered that into BT's ear. And that's how, you know, we're kind of like the offspring, great-great-grandchildren arc is of the beginnings of the ROI dap. And this guy's over in Peru, you know, bought a farm over there, and he's doing ayahuasca, and he's building up really cool stuff, and he's just coming back into the scene. He's looking for a project to believe in, and he asked, hey, what can I watch? Where can I, you know, learn about the ARK. And that's a great thing. Well, there's so much content. Where do we go? Where do we start? See, this would be something amazing for him. And in a short format, you know, he might feel shortchanged. So I personally like it because there's a lot of people that are going to be coming here, especially normies from the real world, the regular Joes and Janes and little Jimmy too, and their ducks. So, yeah, I really like it. Is there anybody else? Udaman. Udaman, man, Udaman's a YouTuber. Let's get some YouTuber feedback. I don't know if you could speak, sir. Looks like Udaman's out of commission. Oh, there you are. Okay. I was just going to pick somebody else. Go ahead, sir. That is a dead radio silence from the Udaman. If there's anybody else, feel free to mute your mic and speak up. Throw your roses to the feet of our great content creator here, Jashan.
I'll chime in real quick. I just want to say good job. You nailed it. For that being your first video, you absolutely nailed it. I mean, you might have a future in this. So keep going, buddy. I see you all the time in the comments and stuff. And like you said, I'm just like you, like with the sweep widget, I'm usually already been in that video or that Medium article. I've already liked it. I've already commented on it. And then, you know, because I'm always seeking ARK videos and ARK Medium articles because I want to see them all too. And you nailed it, man. You hit it right on the head. And keep up the good work and keep pushing, man. And don't worry, your syndicate will grow. You can tell that your heart's there and it's in the right place. So I'm at work at right now, guys, but I just want to chime in quick so I didn't get called on. Thank you, Atlas.
Thank you. All right. We saw Byzy Dips unmute his mic. It is all yours, sir.
Yes, indeed. Fantastic video. Hard to believe it's his first video, but brilliantly executed, well-spoken. I think what we're looking at here is a future star for ARK5.
A 100%. Absolutely. Was there anybody else? Udaman, are you back in radio frequency modulated? Yes, sir. And very well. All right. Thank you.
Great. Yes. So I was running around the neighborhood about 3 miles for a while. But entire time I was listening. And then by the time when he finished his YouTube video, I ran 3 miles. So I was running in the air, actually. So I really like his video and content. He touched everywhere. And then I like the fact that, wait, there's more. And then he keeps going on. I really like it. I really love it. I'm anxious to wait. I'm looking forward to watching his next video. So here's a fan, subscriber. So good luck. And keep going.
I think SK Crypto K, SK Crypto K is going to get a Wells notice. Jashan is on the rise, ladies and gentlemen. You saw it here first. Please don't forget, you know, this amazing day and what a day to have one of our great community leaders, participants here, always here with us, really, you know, have his first day in the light on YouTube. It is a big step. It is a very proud day for us here at the ARK, and we're very proud of Jashan. A day of a 4,000 vault accounts milestone, 850,000 plus in the liquidity, and of course, if you haven't noticed, my friends, a new all-time high on the ARK Spark prize pool. 506.95 ARK, and that is a street value, my friends, of $2,899.75. Sheesh. pinch yourself? Is it really happening?
Oh, yeah. Let's get this crypto.
Yes, sir, it is. And before we unleash the beast, that is the Spark prize pool, we're going to go ahead and give some more free ARK away. Mr. Mistletoe, are you ready, sir, to spin the wheel for today's All Aboard contest?
I am always ready. Give me a second. Should be able to see the wheel there.
We sure do. And how many participants today, sir?
We got 60 today, so we're moving up the slow climb.
All
but
right,
for anyone
sir.
That doesn't on, this is the Sweep Widget Wheel. This is the All Aboard session. Every day we have a new video to go through, the new All Aboard video. And you can actually get your chance to win $50 to $100 worth of ARK by taking 5 minutes out of your day to enter the Sweep Widget, like, comment, and subscribe on all the YouTube channels, and retweet a Twitter link, and that's all you got to do. So get in there. We'll post the new link probably in about half hour here after the podcast, and you can get a head start for tomorrow.
On the count of three, sir. 2, 1.
Mazers, you have won $50 worth of ARK. Congratulations.
Is that a first-time winner over there in the contest?
That is a first-time winner. I've never seen that name win. Let's go.
All right. Okay, let's unleash the beast. And in the spirit of the five little ducks, that brought up a song that made me think, hey, let's play that one tonight. We've never played it here as we get pumped up, ready for releasing another all-time high Spark. Call out Sparky if you want to win tonight, folks. Don't forget.
This morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds, it's by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true. Singing,
this is my message to you. Ooh,
ooh. Singing, don't worry about a thing.
And here we go, folks, to see who tonight's winner is. The suspense builds. Who is it going to be? It's going through all of the wallets. And there it is. This is the qualified wallet, the winner of tonight's Spark Prize. Their wallet ends in 8B A1. And they're the lucky, fortunate winner of another all-time high, 508.94 ARC. And they are first-time winner. Congratulations. Nitro mode. And as a first-time winner, we have a tradition here that we like to do and play the first-time winner jingle. Please do watch your ears. It is loud.
Let's get this crypto.
Oh, God damn. Oh, yeah. Let's get this crypto.
Someone's very, very lucky day. Tuesday, March 28th, sailing on the Ark, Nitro Boost. Boy, are they going to be smiling. If they don't know yet, when they know, smiling ear to ear. Amazing. With that, it is time. We're a little bit over time, but we had a great time. I mean, we were blown away today by Jashawn's video. Just amazing. Made, I think, my week seeing this great gentleman, a great father, a great investor, come and deliver this masterpiece here for us. Mr. Z, how are you doing today, sir?
Hey, everybody.
Are you ready for another DeFi session here with our very own crypto DeFi expert?
Absolutely, Alice. We got some news here. The first thing I want to say is a special thank you to Brandon. He had me on his podcast last night. We went for about an hour. We talked about ARK. We talked about DeFi. So do check his YouTube out for that video. It was pretty insightful. Brandon, are you going to invite me for more? That's the question.
Well, I'll think about it. And of course, dude. Hey, of course.
I'm inviting you. G?
You demanded invites me now as well. Oh, man, I'm going to press
for you. Go. Thank you. Your dance card is full, brother.
Yo, I gotta say, I watched the rerun today. I watched Brandon and Z last, you know, they did last night, but I watched the rerun today before I went to work, and I got to get a good look at Z with that long hair, man. He looks like a young Chris Cornell, man. You freaking shocked me when I seen your face, man. You look great.
Thank you, guys.
He had the Louis Vuitton. He had the jacket on, man. He looked like a supermodel. If you haven't seen it, please do go check it out. It's the last stream Monday. It's about an hour long. Make sure to like, smash the little button, the bell, and leave a comment. Let's get it. It was a great. I watched it too. It was great.
No, that was fun, man. Like, now I've been on YouTube before, but like with Brandon, like me and him have like a flow, man. And I think I'm gonna do many sort of educational podcasts with him. But thank you for the shout out. Our ARK airdrop army did reach 60 members last night, so it's great progress.
Oh, yeah.
So we gave some giveaways and stuff, and we do this for the people, man. We want people to build their portfolios in this bear market, you know, and we're going to do it that way. We're going to go on these YouTubes and we're going to basically give away, we're going to do airdrops, right? Brandon was doing a great airdrop, and I love how he does it with this community. A very interactive community, man. Like whenever he puts his entries up, within like microseconds, like you have 40 plus candidates that sort of fill up the entries. So,
yeah.
Wow. It was really good to see. I mean, but yeah, shout out to Brandon. Shout out to the Drip Gang there. And we'll do many more, and we'll cover many things in DeFi. So that was great. The other thing, the announcement I want to make is much more spiritual. As we know, in America, we've had two cases where the folks in Mississippi sort of went through a tornado. So we make a prayer out for them and the lives of the people there. And then we know about what happened in Nashville, heinous debacle. And we have to just make a prayer out and keep people, you know, like we're enjoying ourselves in crypto and, you know, we're able to live our lives in such a way. But, you know, people are suffering in the world. So we make a prayer out to there. So yeah, along that way, I want to talk about some the ZK, the sort of ZK EVM sort of thing is just starting, guys. Like we went through ZK Sync this week. We went through a Polygon ZK EVM launch. I was actually able to find the YouTube video where Polygon did a 2-hour thing, and you had Vitalik do the first transaction on the on the Polygon ZK EVM. So if you guys want to check that out, I think it's about 20 minutes into this 2-hour sort of summit. And here you can see him do the very first transaction on the Polygon ZK EVM. And a really, really cool, insightful thing. You had Mihal, you had Sandeep from Polygon, and you had the whole team really discuss the future of DeFi. And you had, you know, folks like Vitalik. So do check out that YouTube video. I did put it out on the DeFi links. And so whilst we had two major sort of ZK EVM rollups with ZK Sync and Polygon, we were joined by Consensys. So Consensys, as we know, is the company behind MetaMask, is the company behind Infura, and Web3 is multi dependent on what happens with Consensys. So Consensys also released their ZK EVM. So we're going to kind of look into this as well. And they raised a big amount of money, and they had a bunch of Silicon Valley money. They had companies like Microsoft that funded it. So the title here reads, Consensys launches ZK EVM. One second. Public testnet renames its to Linea. So they're calling it Linea. So the release comes in days after competitors Polygon and Matter Labs came out with their own ZK EVM. I'm really liking this space, because it just shows when you have competition from these big guys like Matter Labs for the ZK Sync, and then you have Polygon, and now you have Consensys, the company behind your MetaMask and Infura, like all sort of I would say competing at a friendly term, but they're making things much faster, and they're giving the customers, us the user base, more choices when it comes to you can say play to earn gaming, or if it's a NFT minting mechanism, or if it's a launchpad mechanism, to make things much faster. So Linea is their ZK virtual machine. So Linea represents the next evolution of Consensys ZK EVM, powering a new generation of dApps built on Ethereum. So we have zero knowledge in the building here, right? So ZK technology is seen by many as the ultimate expansion system for blockchain by increasing the speed of transaction and reducing their fees. So ZK, you know, is in the scene, and Consensys released Linea. And I did put out this Twitter thread that came out today as well, by Atoms Research. If you guys want to follow a good place for DeFi knowledge and stuff, do follow Atoms Research on Twitter. Linea testnet by Consensys. Linea is a type 2 zero knowledge Ethereum virtual machine that replicates an Ethereum environment by leveraging rollups. We've talked about rollups a lot in the past. So at the beginning, Consensys announced the launch of a closed beta test, which could only be accessed by filling out a form Today they announced the launch of the public testnet. So, you know, whenever I see public testnets, I think about airdrops. So we will talk about this post. But yeah, there is a bunch of instructions here how you can do testnet stuff and basically do some swaps and stuff and be able to participate in these things. I want people from the ARC to participate in these things actively. One thing I wanted to cover was how much... how much funds was raised and who was involved, because there were some big, I think it was $795 million that was raised, and it included big Silicon tech companies like Microsoft. So we will keep an eye on Consensus and their updates on ZKEVM, but we will, in the airdrop army, we will look into the airdrop side of things as this thread shows. And so yeah, that's the news on ZKEVM. Let's see what else is in the news. The other news was Circle, USDC. So USDC launched on Cosmos ecosystem. As the title reads, so Circle, stablecoin USDC to launch on Cosmos. By the way, guys, are you able to see my screen? Because I'm scared.
Yep,
I'm
we not sure.
Awesome. Thank you, Mistletoad. So yeah, so it's so a Circle stablecoin USDC to launch on Cosmos. Cosmos will finally have its own native stablecoin. Circle partnering with crypto startup Noble to deploy USDC directly to the ecosystem. USDC will be the native stablecoin on Atom, which is pretty cool. USDC is the second largest stablecoin in the cryptocurrency ecosystem behind Tether and is pivotal to many decentralization DeFi projects. It is often used as a collateral for lending and borrowing for general yield. And now they are going to be on our Cosmos ecosystem. So this was a quote from Noble CEO Jelena Jurek, and this is what they had to say. So that's about to change with Noble's first issuance partner, Circle. They're bringing a native USDC to Cosmos for the first time. Big news. It's Cosmos, I think, holds about, I think, to 12 to 15 million users on its ecosystem. So now they'll be able to trade using USDC. So that's the news on USDC. Let's keep going. Yeah, I think yesterday we kind of covered the Binance, lawsuit by the CFTC, and I think we are going to basically hear more insights into this as we get through. But the title here reads, "Here's why CFTC suing Binance is a bigger deal than SEC enforcement." So the accusation that the CFTC are making is Binance, without the licensing that you need to trade these sort of like leveraged things, these sort of assets, they didn't have the license for it, and they allowed American users to be generating and making these leverage moves. But thus far, Binance has denied a bunch of this and said in the last couple of years, they've actually stopped US-based investors from making deposits, and they have proof of that. So we're going to keep learning more and more about this legal claim, and we'll keep you updated. Some people say it was a political move. Some people say they're just picking on everybody, including Coinbase and all the big guns. And we can all make our own storylines, but it's important for us to understand the filing and understand where this is going. So hopefully in these DeFi sessions, we can kind of break that down. But the case study's out, and we'll see how this thing breaks down, and we'll keep you inundated. But I think that sort of covers the DeFi sessions for today. Appreciate all of you. Do join the ARC airdrop army. We are 60 members now. And for people that are new here, it's an easy sort of, you go to the Discord, you go to server desk, and you'll see a roles channel there. You click there, and you can just click the little parachute guy there. and you'll be able to you'll unlock all these subcategories here called the Airdrop Army, and then we're going to cover all these things. And I think Linea will be a new channel that I'm going to add here, so we can cover that testnet as well. But we are going to do ZK Sync through the week, and we'll actually specify a day where we can all come together. It could be a Thursday or a Friday where we come here about 7 p.m. UTC, and we do the testnet activities together. It's a good thing for ARC because we will be doing testnet stuff when we build our layers in DeFi very, very soon. And once we start needing people to test out, maybe the ARC folks here will have already earned airdrops on so many other sort of mainnets like SCI, Quay, ZK Sync, and then we can do the same thing on ARC. So yeah, guys, thank you so much.
And thank you, sir. All right. Great DeFi sessions. Is there anybody that has a question for Mr. Z? Today, I'm just finishing up here sending to the announcements channel and something else. So I just need about 30 seconds.
Yeah, I got a question for Z real quick. When's the next VC for the Discord for the airdrop thing?
Yeah, we're planning to do it, I believe, every Thursday. A Thursday seems to be a day where it's not taking up anyone's weekend. And what we can do is once a week we can get together and be doing all the tasks on things like like this week I want to cover ZK Sync. So I will make an announcement. I wanted to do a survey. I did ask a lot of people in that are already in the airdrop scene what works best for them. So thus far it's rolling out to be a Thursday 7 p.m. UTC, but I'll keep you updated. Yeah, man. We have to be part of all these things, man. We got to be part of all these test nets. We have to, because I think what happens is it makes it easier for folks to adapt to different things. So like when Atom or Cosmos or ZK Sync or any of these EVMs do an interoperability layer where we're like adapting to, maybe ARC builds on ZK Snarks, right? And by the time we've done all the testnet activities, we'll be in sync with that. So let's go. Let's do these tasks.
We will be ready to take over the crypto streets and keep everybody afloat and comfortable, safe, away from the crypto abyss. Something really interesting happened in today's podcast. I don't know if any of you folks have been keeping track with the buys, but Jashaun, you got to keep making more of those videos because a max wallet, 25,650 BUSD happened right when we were showing your video, my friend. Sheesh. They got educated. They got taken to school. They got the five duck strategy and they aped into ARC. Amazing. Amazing.
Beautiful. Let's go.
I was going to mention it too during the podcast, but I didn't want to take away from how awesome that video was, to be honest.
I think it was a catalyst. I mean, Mr. Catalyst has to be on fire today with so many milestones being crossed today from the 4,000, accounts in ARC. And I was seeing, as we were here, more accounts starting to open up as we started the podcast. And then when Jashaun started, we started to look at his video, that massive max wallet buy came in. It pushed our TVL much higher. And just another vote. I can assure you folks that someone that's coming and dropping $25,000 into a project, is that something that happens all the time or every day? And generally, the folks that can afford to do that are very smart money investors. They know what they're doing. They've taken the time. They're doing the research. Maybe they're here or were here when it happened live. you know, dropping the vote of confidence for all of us to see, hey, folks, hey, ARC, hey, community, keep doing what you're doing. Because there's nobody out there that really does it the way the ARC does. There just isn't. It's not talking about anybody else. It's just, you know, pointing out something that stands out to any investor when they come here. I'm in other groups. I go to other projects, AMAs, and I listen and I hear what those guys do at ARC. No one has been able to accomplish that. The community is something so amazing because everybody's a winner here. And where do you find that in crypto? Where everyone is a winner. I haven't seen it yet until the ARC.
Nobody.
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 Does it better.
I think I know where the big buy came in. I think there's more coming along. a shout out to whoever you are. We know who you are. Thank you.
Smart money. The smart money, my friend. It keeps coming in. Catalyst, you wanted to share something here before we finish the recording. Go to Q&A.
Yeah, another thing that happened during that awesome video that we all got to watch was a Platinum Legacy NFT was minted during the video.
Let's go. That was probably the same person. I would not doubt it. You know, because if you're going to get a max wallet, if you're going to get the jumbo jet, you're going to want the Platinum NFT. It just goes hand in hand.
Of course. And the Gucci bag.
Didn't notice that. Thank you. I can see here on my private dashboard. Let me take a quick look. Let me see here. Actually, let me refresh because that's a number I had earlier a couple of hours ago before that Platinum came in.
43 yep. minutes ago.
I see it. Yes, sir. And I believe, yeah, some other ones are printed too, because I'm seeing a much higher balance, which brings us to 524,800 for our investment fund. Sheesh. Watch out. Here we come. Can't beat us, get on board. Just come and start earning with us, boys. Be on the winning team. Be on the right side of the printers here at ARC. We got you, baby. So a day full of milestones all around, all-time high this. You know, milestone breaking on the ARC vault accounts. Liquidity on PancakeSwap, breaking the 850K. I mean, we're going to hit that 900 and then it's a million. I mean, how wonderful can it be? Got to pinch yourself sometimes. With that, we want to conclude tonight's podcast. We've gone an hour and 30 minutes, but it was all worth it. It always is. We're going to stay, have a Q&A after we finish the recording. Shout out to tonight's lucky winner, over 500 ARC. That is massive, folks. That is taking someone into a exponential level of earning that is mind-blowing. Your grandmother's ROI app doesn't have that. I can assure you, my friend, we do. And that's why they come. They come for the foundation as well, your high-yield savings account. They come for the legacy NFT. I mean, there's so many ways to flourish, not just survive. Just flourish and thrive on the ARC. Thank you, Jashan, for an amazing video. We are fanboys. We're looking forward to more content when the time is right. We've got a rising star here, ladies and gentlemen. And there will be more people that are going to get involved. A lot of stars are going to be born and they're going to rise on the move. For the folks that are listening to the recording at a later date, thank you also for your participation. We hope that you found the recording educational as well as entertaining. And we'll be back tomorrow again at our new time, 4 p.m. EST, 8 p.m. UTC. Everyone, take care of yourselves. Take care of everyone you love. We'll see you soon.